Morning guys, Scott from SE Landscaping. Back on the schools today and we're just going to be doing a little bit of cutting with our Ransomes. We've had a lot of rain this week, but as you can see, the grass is starting to shoot away. So we'll get a bit of footage, a little bit of cutting with our Silver de Moir. Stay tuned.
I've learned more than you ever knew. services, services. Hey, we don't need no one to tell us what's right or wrong. This is a modern world. This is a modern world.
So guys, this school is one of our contracts that is maintained on a fortnightly basis. So as you can see through the growing season, the main pitch, what you saw there, the main grassed area, was quite long. But the good thing with this cylinder mower is it gets down and does a nice tidy job. These small bits here as well, yes, you've got to know how to use the machine, but these small tight bits, the machine can still get in. Yes, some people would say, why not use a smaller machine? But we come here with this and some smaller hand machines, so it is easy for me. Use these machines for sort of 20 years. It's easier for me just to cut it with this machine. There's one or two marks on the ground because it has been wet the last few days, but overall, once you get on the main field and you're not turning and twisting, the machine does a really nice cut and doesn't leave much mess behind. So, but like you can see here, I mean, it's really tight around these trees, and you've got very little space. But like I say, I've been driving these a long time, and I'm used to doing tight areas as well as larger areas. Yes, we all prefer to cut large areas with limited obstacles, but it is what it is. The tape you can see on the play equipment, basically the play equipment is still out of action due to COVID. Play equipment up here in the northeast, as elsewhere, is still out of action until further notice. So once we finish each visit, we put fresh tape on anything that needs anything that's fallen off or been pulled off or blown off with the wind. We will re-tape, and like I say, the strimming is to do next. But like I said, with this machine, with the cylinder, it leaves very little strimming as well, as you can see. A couple of tight obstacles, but apart from that, there's very little left. So the parkway, I mean, it lasts a day and a half on a full tank of fuel, so you don't need to fill it up every day if you don't want to. It is a really good machine. I've been driving these for 20 years and there's some good new additions to how they used to be years ago. The computer on board is a lot more technical now, but that helps the machine, to be honest, and helps the operator because you know what's going wrong. So yeah, three cylinders. One downside is sometimes you blow a hydraulic pipe and you don't know that you've blown hydraulic pipe, and you could have hydraulic oil leaking out the back for a while. So it's always nice every time you go on tarmac to have a look behind just to see if there's any drips or things. But yeah, this is all computerized now, so your fuel levels are there, your hydraulic oil levels are there, which same again, if you see that dropping, you know you've got a leak. So that helps. And everything else going forward is on this compared to years ago, where it was there was no computer. It was all you had to look for your diesel on a little line on the side of the machine. Anybody who used these will know. The three green lights even tell you which cylinders are down, which is good. And the orange stroke yellow light tells you that you couldn't. So years ago, same again, you'd sometimes put a middle cylinder down and it wouldn't cut if it was blocked or something, whereas this does. So yeah, great machine. Great finish there, as you can see. And thanks for watching. And if you like what you see, please like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks, guys.